How was your Valentine's Day?
Wala kasi kaming kasama dito sa bahay, so hindi kami maka-sneaky.
Sabi mo yung totoo. To be honest, basta katabi ko sa China, okay na ako.
What's up, Pushmates? Welcome to another episode of Pushbacks Live. This is Gary. I hope you guys had a very special Valentine's Day. Pero kung hindi naman, okay lang yan. Bawi na lang tayo sa mga susunod pang taon. At syempre, dahil Love Month ngayon, sasamahan tayo ng isa sa mga sikat na celebrity couples in the local showbiz industry. Please welcome Kian Cipriano and Chyna Hortaleza. Kumusta naman kayo? How was your Valentine's Day?
Hindi na ako magsasalita. I don't wanna give too much information, but how was it?
No, it was actually quite fun because we like to cuddle. So we spent that day cuddling, but this time, since we have two kids, kasama namin si Stellar in Salem sa cuddling session namin.
Sabi mo yung totoo.
I wish it could be have been more action-packed, guys, but... But, yun nga, so, wala kasi kaming, ano, diba, wala kasi kaming kasama dito sa bahay, so hindi kami maka-sneaky, so kasama namin yung kids namin buong Valentine's Day. Which is fun, I like
it. Yes!
Yeah.
Parang ano ah, marami pang nangyari ng Valentine's Day. But do you guys have, you know, a tradition?
Tradition? Simple lang kasi kami ni Kian eh. Mahilig lang kami sa masarap na pagkain. At saka,
yep.
Ano pa? Go!
Well, basta masarap. Okay kami sa masarap. Parang, simple lang kami. I mean, Valentine's Day, Christmas, birthdays. It's really ano eh, yung magkakasama lang kami, we eat together, we pray together. Yun na yun eh. Parang nothing like super extravagant, you know, but
yung company kasi namin talaga yung favorite part namin lagi. So
right.
Basta present kami dun sa every day, every moment, yan.
But before lagi kasi tumatapat na parang pag Valentine.
May gig
or parang na like 2 years ago, Valentine's na sa ano ko, Bahrain.
Yeah, oh, nga pala, diba? You're in Bahrain. Oo. So, yeah, usually he has to play kasi during Valentine's Day. It's either I join him or the last time he went to Bahrain. So,
or okay UP naman. Fair, ganyan,
UP
diba?
Fair, ganyan.
Talagang maganda itong this year kasi magkasama lang kayo, diba? And of course, with the kids. And ito na nga, no, kasi isa sa mga masasabi nating common issue about couples with kids, minsan nakakalimutan na mag-spend ng time together ng just the two of you. Kayo ba nangyayari ito sa inyo? Or do you always make sure to, you know, na laging may time kayo together na kayong dalawa lang?
Before, yeah, it was far easier to do that.
Mm-hmm.
But now, kasi syempre, we do everything at home. So we work from home and we also take care of the kids here. We try our best to try to sneak in kahit a couple of minutes. Or even, ano nga eh, masaya na kami ni Kian na kungwari pagtulog pa yung mga bata. Let's say sa umaga na una kami gumising, we just have like simple breakfast together. Tapos usap lang kami. Ganyan yung mga moments namin. Or in case talagang walang ganon, kungwari may chores kami, we talk while we do chores.
Yeah, it's different eh. It's different because iba yung you spend time together na kumbaga may activity kayo, let's say, together dun sa palagi na kayo magkasama together. Kasi yeah. Kami ni Chyna, palagi magkasama together, labo. Pero kami ni Chyna kasi lagi kami magkasama. Kasi every single second of the day, magkasama kami. But yung tanong siguro is yung parang quality time. Yun yung sinisingit namin as much as kaya namin. Pero ako, to be honest, basta katabi ko si Chyna, okay na ako.
Nakaka-miss ha. Nakaka-miss din na nagde-date kami.
Oh,
kasi dati, masaya na kami if we're able to just leave the kids with my mom and then we go on like a movie date. Or
even papamasahe kami.
Oo, ganun. We miss that. But syempre, we have to learn to adjust during this time. And maging creative din, di ba? Kung paano kami makakapag-spend time with each other.
Yeah.
And speaking of the kids, kamusta naman ngayon si Nesteller and Salem?
Ayun, super cool. Ayun, kulit.
Kakasabi ko lang, kids, quiet. Ayun. Sumigaw. We have the sweetest kids
super,
in the world.
Super.
They're amazing. They're everything. Pero balance lang din siguro yung mundo na dahil lumalaki sila magkasabay, yung kulit level nila iba rin.
Oo, nakaka-test siya ng patience, yeah. Nakaka-test siya ng... Fairness, para siyang gym para sa aming dalawa for understanding and patience and love and self-control. Ganon siya. Kasi kumbaga, nandiyan sila, lumalaki sila. Siyempre, adorable naman talaga. Nakikita mo lahat, sobrang nakakatuwa. Yun yung at parang plus ng nandito kami kasama nila day in and day out. You see every milestone that happens, which is great. But then at the same time, they also develop their quirks.
Yeah.
Diba? So, yung mga quirks na yun, kailangan namin balansin ni Kia na there's some sort of discipline, of course, that needs to be put in. But at the same time, ayaw naman namin like completely sabihin sa mga anak namin na don't explore or yeah. Diba, don't foster this personality. Kasi sila yan eh. Mm. And I think we need to be able to let them grow despite the fact na they know na we're just in the same home.
They're growing up so fast. Mm-hmm. Super fast. So, nakikita mo, parang nagmamature sila. Nakikita mo yung yung panganay ko si Stellar. Nakikita mo na yung mga lumalabas na yung preferences niya, lumalabas na yung views niya sa buhay. Alam mo yun?
So, wow!
It's weird. Parang, tas nakikita mo lumalaki sila, tas parehas kayo ng mukha.
Oo, parang kanina lang actually, sobra akong nagulat. Kasi apparently, they were watching a movie last night. Kasi yun yung usually pampatulog namin, pamilya. And then, she saw a movie with Kian. Love is Blind ata. And then she played it and then she saw me. So kanina may komentaryo siya sa akin tungkol dun sa performance ko kasi natulog ako ahead then. So, sabi niya, Mom, ang dami yung sinasabi tungkol dun sa performance. Ganyan, sabi ko, nako, creative bata pa lang.
Wow, pero curious ako, ano yung comment niya? Ang bata pa, di ba, pero, di ba, very independent siya mag-isip. That's really, really nice.
Yeah, actually,
para siyang matanda.
Oo, parang she told me na, Mom, you know what, I really like the way you looked in the movie. And sabi niya, you should try to look like that every day. And then sabi niya, I saw your scene when you were doing this. Tapos nag-flip siya ng hair niya. Kasi meron ako parang sobra kasing exaggerated yung character ko sa Love is Blind. So, ginagaya niya yung pagka-turn around ko. Tapos piniflip niya yung buong hair niya. Tapos natatawa lang ako kasi parang grabe sobrang absorbent ng mga bata.
Sa akin, wild yung sinabi niya.
I wouldn't
say. What did you feel when you kissed that girl?
Oh!
What did you feel? Were you in love?
Oh! But those are, intelligent questions actually, di ba?
Yeah. She's sabi nga ni Kian, she's actually growing up pretty fast and it's just mm-hmm. to be able to see and foster that.
Yes, may critical thinking na at such a young age, di ba? At maganda rin ang timing kasi you guys, talaga napapantayan nyo sila growing up dahil di ba magkakasama sa household all the time.
Yeah. Yes. Oo, super. Like ako, pinaka-thankful ako. The past year and this year, kumbaga my priorities as a mother were really like laid out na sobrang clear niya for me. And I'm very happy that I'm able to be with them like 24/7 and help them grow every day. So it's a big achievement for us as parents.
We learn a lot.
Yeah, we learn a lot from our children. Hindi siya yung parang one-way street lang eh. In terms of like how you cope, how you live your life, and how you manage kumbaga everything, even if parang feeling natin there's a lot of problems, a lot of conflicts, there's anxiety and stuff like that that's happening. But if you look at your children and you see how they live their life, that's inspiration right there. Yeah. Kasi nakikita mo talaga they're happy, they're
saka okay na, okay na. I mean, siguro isang malaking blessing para sa amin ni China na meron kaming little kids ngayon na nangyayari itong pandemic na to. Kasi sila yung pambalanse.
Yeah.
Sila yung parang whenever you feel down or nag-worry ka, ngitian ka lang ng bata, okay na. Yakapin ka lang ng bata, okay na. So, we're lucky.
Yeah, so sila talaga yung nagpapasaya, di ba? Yeah. Yun na nga, last year, si Kian, nakapag-guest siya rito, di ba? And yes. We talked about the struggles na kinaharap niya as a family during the quarantine. Kamusta na ba kayo ngayon?
We're good,
actually.
Better,
yes.
Yeah, kumbaga, after the initial shock, everybody went through that naman. I think everybody was like in a period of shock for a couple of weeks. Diba?
Yeah, especially especially for musicians like me, for
actors like me.
Actors din na para sa entertainment industry, diba? Parang biglang,
we're used to be like, we're out and about, day in and day out.
Yeah.
Plus, of course, you know, we run a record label, which also, like, really consumes a lot of our time. We're out of the house as early as 9 a.m. And then, that's it. We come home just to sleep. Ganun kami. But throughout this pandemic, all I can say is after going through the adjustments that we needed to go through, I just feel like, yun nga, since everything is laid out so perfectly na parang nakita namin yung mga dapat i-prioritize and pinaka-necessary sa life. Now, going into 2021, we really have a positive mindset going in.
Kasi safe to say, nakapag-adjust naman.
Yeah, we were able to adjust. Plus, yun nga, I'm very happy with how the past year has molded us as individuals, as partners, and parents and a family. Talagang kumbaga sabi ko, ang ganda ng lessons.
Yeah, yes.
Level 1,000.
Oo.
Yeah, na talagang 2020 is a year of lessons, di ba? It's for everyone. Ganun na nangyari talaga. But now, I'm so glad that you guys are so much better. And yun nga, being a parent alone is tough. Alam naman natin yan. But you're still able to juggle yung parenthood and being entrepreneurs. Dahil meron kayong record label, the OC Records. Can you guys tell us how it's like to be executives ng ganitong klaseng business?
It's a different, it's a different realm. Parang, before, ang sanay lang ako na iniisip ko lang yung sarili ko, how am I gonna make this career work? How am I gonna keep my family afloat, myself parang fulfilled sa mga ginagawa ko? And, nung nabigyan kami ni Chila ng chance to own and run our own record label, doon ko nakita at na-appreciate lahat ng mga tao rin na tumulong sa amin sa buong career namin. Because it's to be honest, to answer your question, ng isang word, it's hard. It's hard to run a record label. Well, like any other business, di ba? Yeah. Hindi naman talaga madali. Pero hindi na lang kasi art yung iniisip mo eh. Hindi na lang yung
it's not just always the creative side that comes to play. I mean, it's good. All I can say is when we started, when we were blessed with OC, the journey in itself has already made us better artists because balancing ngayon yung view namin. If before we were just focused on the performances, the creative side of what we're doing, but now that we have a record label, we're also focusing on the business side.
Which I think is something na sana natutunan ko early on. Kasi hindi ko siya natutunan kaagad dati. Dahil nga iniisip ko lang, art lang to. I don't care about the money. I just wanna do what I love and, you know, do this for the rest of my life. Pero nung namulat nga ako at nandito na ako sa ganitong field, sa behind the scenes, actually. Dun sa, kumbaga, if you call it the music business, before I'm just pure music. Ngayon, music business na pagsasama ko na siya. Alam mo yun? So masasabi ko na alam na namin yung mundo na ginagalawa namin. And daming learnings, dami rin pagbabago sa perspective at sa view namin as artists. Kasi...
Yeah, because before you tend to like take for granted, as you were saying, all the people that you come across, no, in your career. But now that we're actually doing things behind the scenes, all of a sudden, I see the value of each person that comes into play when it comes to your career.
Because you can't do it alone.
Yeah, like even the smallest people, or parang, no, not the smallest.
Walang smallest.
People, walang smallest. Yeah. Like even kumbaga, people that you just come across, hindi mo man sila like kasama araw-araw sa karera mo, pero yung mga tao na, let's say,
kahit yung smallest contribution.
Yeah, naatasan na mag-inquire tungkol sa'yo. Magsulat tungkol sa'yo. Lahat ng mga tao yan ay very important because hindi magagawang maganda ang karera at lalong hindi magiging successful ang karera ng isang artist kung siya lang ang gagawa.
Yeah, but
that's what we try to impart to our artists also because we want them to have a balanced view as early as day one.
Yeah.
Gusto namin na maturuan sila nung balance na yun.
Baga no bullshit, di ba? Talagang straight up. Kasi yun eh. Answer ang parang pinakamasarap din na pakiramdam now that we're running this business. May ano eh, every day you learn.
Yeah.
Every day you talk to different artists, you learn something about them, nagre-reflect yun sa sarili mo. So, lahat na apply mo. And fun part din ng pagkakaroon ng record label, I get to listen to different types of music every single day.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? So parang siyang isang malaking sound trip. Diba? But yun nga yung nasa harap. Yun yung fun part. Pero yung business side, fun part din siya. Fun part siya definitely. Pero yun yung very tedious.
Yeah, because you cannot not attend to it day in and day out. You've got to study the numbers, you got to look into the numbers, you know, these things, you know. Before, honestly, when I was an artist, I really didn't pay attention. There would be days when I'd even, like, laugh and question ratings and, you know, stuff like that. Parang ako, why is it even important? But now I know why it's important and why you have to look into it as an artist as well. And what's nice about how Kian and I have been trying to mold the label. We are always for creative freedom. We trust the artists that trust us. Kasi parang sabi ko nga kay Kian, malaki talaga yung naitutulong din sa amin ng bawat artist na nakakausap namin at minumolde namin. Kasi each person is so unique and has something to contribute to the world, to art, and to the industry in itself, na yun yung gusto namin i-foster. Gusto namin silang i-empower. Kumbaga, gusto namin alam nila na may mga naniniwala dun sa unique capabilities na binigay sa kanila ng ni God, diba? I mean, yeah. Siya yun eh. Hindi lang yung artist yun eh. It's being given to them. It's a blessing. It's a gift from the higher power. And kami ni Kian, we're just here to weave, to help make those dreams a reality. So that's how we really conduct everything in the label.
At least try to make those dreams come true.
Yeah, we try to empower them as much as we can.
Because we dream with them. Diba? We dream with the artists. We join their journey, their musical journey, and that I'm very thankful. Kasi yun eh, parang eventually we're all gonna grow old and babalikan lang natin, oh, we did something cool before, we did something great. Iba yung business kasi na to eh, di ba? Minsan okay, minsan hindi. Ganon
even,
siya.
Even yung views ng artist, di ba, Gary? Parang minsan okay sila and then the following day, hindi na sila okay.
Yes.
We are just happy with being given like a time in their career to help them out.
Saya ako every time na may nakita ako na like artist na nag-grow as an artist and as an individual. Malaking ano yun. Baga na napapangiti ako palagi noon pag oy nag-grow siya, oh, ang laki na nung mature niya, oh, galing na niya ngayon na dati hindi siya ganun ka like confident ngayon.
Ganda rin makita pag niya. Nagbo-bloom kasi yung tao,
yeah.
Alam
but
yun.
In the middle of that journey, may mga frustrations, may parang oh my gosh, sayang ganito ganyan, but ano eh parte siya. Parte siya.
May mga panahon na hindi rin kayo nagkikita eye to eye as, diba, parang mentor,
relationship
manager.
Relationship.
Relationship siya eh. So it's really like a it's a commitment.
Kasi and, kasi before ako, parang dahil nga nagsimula kami ni Chino sa embassy na ito ng mga bata pa, I didn't know anything about my contracts, to be honest. Mm-hmm. Parang, oh, a contract. This contract, what does it say? It's gonna make me a star. Or you're gonna be a recording artist. So sign this contract, diba? But yun yung before I didn't care. Pero now I deal with contracts every single day, and nakikita ko yung value ng kumbaga bilang artist. Dapat alam mo yung laman nun, diba? And bilang entrepreneur, dapat din alam mo yung binibigay mo na kontrata sa mga tao sa mo. Kasi ano yun eh, parang handbook yun eh, parang ano yun eh. Hindi yung pangawa ka
niya. Black and white yan, basis yan ng lahat ng
tao. So yeah, to answer the question, it's ano na ngayon, mas malawak na ngayon yung nangyayari.
Yeah. At ang galing, no? Kasi, I mean, like, ang dalim, like, kahanga-hanga yung deep insights ninyo about this. At talaga maano mo na itong mga insights na to, it won't come from somebody na, ano, basta-basta lang. Ito talaga yung magagaling to somebody na maraming pinagdaanan, you know? And talaga makikita na ang laki ng miniature ninyo, you know, you've grown so much dito sa inyong business. Pero maiba muna tayo, we heard that you guys have an upcoming single together. Diba? Tungkol saan po ba ito?
Actually, si Kian talaga yung tagapilit sa akin na gumawa ng music. Kasi dati, I was trying to dabble into that form of expression. And I'm thankful to him because he encouraged me. Na parang, sige, labas mo yung music mo. May pwede kang sabihin. So this single, actually, matagal na tong kanta na to sa amin. Ilang years na rin siya.
We wrote this song when we were in our first home.
I was about to give birth.
Yeah, she's about to give birth. Tapos parang nasulat namin yung kanta sa dining table namin. Tapos, yeah, it's called Walk on Water. The song is about each other. And baga, it's about ano eh, parang believing in miracles. Parang kami ni China, nagkasama kami. It's a big miracle for me na magkaroon ako ng partner. Wow, thank you.
Yes.
Tapos na magkaroon ng baby.
Yeah,
so yun yung sinasabi
nito. The conception process in itself, di ba, parang alam naman natin kung gaano ka miraculous ang ganyan na blessing talaga. And apart from that, over the years, initially, di ba, parang he wrote it with that kind of perspective. But after going through so many things in our marriage, losing both our fathers, and also like going through so many challenges day in and day out, and even personal struggles, parang the song has, kumbaga, really evolved for us. It's more of like really believing in, yun nga, a higher power that will help you through it. And even if it's an impossible feat, diba, there's somebody there who will guide you through.
Yeah.
So it's about faith, miracles, you know. So we decided to finally give birth to it. We've been keeping it for a while. I wasn't ready to release it before, but I think this is the perfect time to actually release the song. So yeah, we're gonna be releasing Walk on Water, finally, after so many years.
Yes, at nako, malaman ng mga lyrics nito for sure. Balita din namin, the cover art was made by you, China, and your daughter, Stellar! Wow!
Oo, kasi talaga tong si Stellar, ano siya, mahilig siyang like to dabble into art, ganyan. I really encourage it. Kian and I keep on encouraging her kasi talagang sobrang nakikita ko yung happiness when she does that. And it was also the day when Kian told the team that he wanted for us to release the song. And Kian, like kami naman ni Stellar, we were playing lang kasi yun yung activity, bonding namin yung magnani talaga. We draw, we paint, tapos sobrang last trip lang kasi it's actually put on tissue. Kasi parang we were just playing with our, ano, with the paint, and then nung ginano namin siya sa tissue, parang sabi ko kay Tina, oh look! Sabi niya, it looks like the ocean, Mom. So sabi ko, oh, do you think we can actually use this for Walk on Water? Because she knows that song. She's aware of that song. She also sings that song. And she said, yeah! So yun na. After that, I sent it to Sean Ferrer, our digital head. And that's it. We had, yun na, single art na namin siya.
Yeah, good thing. Good thing we didn't really have to pay. So, buti na lang marunong gumawa ng art yung anak ko pati asawa ko. So parang hindi na ako nahirapan na, sino kayang pwede gumawa ng single art?
Saka yun, nag-decide na pa-oo niya kasi siya talaga music. And looks like the ocean,
Yeah, at saka ganda, this is like talagang family affair itong ano, song na to. Talagang ito is made by your family, di ba?
Yeah, and I hope people will kumbaga feel encouraged when they listen to this song.
Well, we're very excited for that. Pero ito, sino-sino pa ba ang mga artists under OC Records?
Ako, we have a lot. Actually, over last, yung pandemic time, I'm so proud of the label and also like the whole team because we didn't stop. Parang we really wanted to keep on looking for artists who had something to say, who wanted to put their music out there. Kasi syempre during that time, nakita mo naman kung gano'n nag-flourish ang artistry. Kasi naniniwala ako na, of course, during, during these tough times and extremely happy times and even the plateaus in your life, you really have a lot to say. And nagkataon last year, it was a time of like talagang roller coaster of emotions and we were getting a lot of artists who were eager to share their music.
Kasi stable kasi namin, I think we have like 50 artists, no? But meron mga artists na bago namin na-meet, meron naman na matagal na namin kasama, like, of course, si Unique is the very first OC artist. Si Unique, Frizzle Ann, si Rice Lucido, Earl Henerao, Dito and the Butterflies, yun yung parang first na nag-launch kami, we had 5 artists, 2018. And then,
started growing.
Ngayon, may iba-iba ng klase ng tunog, iba-ibang genre.
Parang midway into the journey, we came across the busking community and then we saw like a tremendous amount of raw talent in their community. So Martin Riggs is part of that. And then Papel, Eugene Layo, and then Eliza is part of that.
So last year, we were able to sign Sean Jr.
Yeah.
Jade Ivy.
Ang dami.
Yeah.
Last year, parang kumbaga, it was amazing na we were able to sign a lot of artists.
And before kasi parang yung tunog nung OC, kumbaga parang we're happy na we're able to parang contribute something na medyo, ngayon nakakuha ako na reaction sa, oy, bagay sa OC.
Tunog OC.
Parang ganon, na kahit anong genre pa, pero alam nilang pwedeng ilagay sa OC, yun yung nakukuha kong parang malaking compliment.
Yeah, but the addition of like the rhythm and blues.
Rhythm and drip.
Rhythm and blues sound.
Ah, okay. Kind of. Rhythm and drip, bago artist din namin.
I was about, come on. See, okay. He just preempted things. The addition of like, yun nga, the hip-hop, rhythm and blues sound. There's also like, parang, I'm so proud of the fact that I hear a lot of their influences. Kasi nga, marami dito Gen Z. So, nakikinig sila ng 90s. Nung bata sila. And then, pag narinig mo yung music na nilalabas nila, I hear a lot of it. And ako, lumaki ako nung era na yun. So, na-enjoy ko talaga na these kids are using their roots, their influences when it comes to their music.
Yeah. Now. At happy rin ako na we're able to expand yung roster namin na before we just had music artists but now we have writers, directors,
influencers,
kumbaga tumatawid na siya. We signed Dora Dorado last year. Iba-iba yung mga nahawakan namin na talents ngayon.
Yeah. But it's definitely, ano, parang nakikita ko na a lot of the artists who also trust us, they're headstrong, very, kumbaga parang, their character is so unique, you know, they know themselves and have a lot to say about themselves, and they are very committed to their music, their art. So, nakakatuwa na, yun nga, natatap kami to help them out.
Well, thank you so much for sharing a lot with us. And I'm sure itong mga artists nyo, they're very talented. Kaya naman, makikipagchikahan tayo sa kanila, okay?